All right, so as Axe was telling us, Anthony Bourdain, Kate Spade, surprising losses, but they did not die in a surprising way. Suicide is a dirty secret in our society. It is a plague that has taken more lives every year for decades. We don't talk about it because, as Axe said, there is a stigma and a shame attached. Even the phone number on the screen, all right, we put it up there. It's good. It's good to get the information out there. It's good to give people a chance. But there's an assumption, and it's that people in that kind of pain will have the will to ask for help. But too often, they do not. The rest of us feel powerless to do anything, especially when the person in need never says anything. But maybe that's because we're not asking them the right questions. But you can. And in doing so, you might just help stop a suicide. Please do this for me and for yourself. Search online for Columbia Protocol for Suicide Prevention. Columbia Protocol for Suicide Prevention. I also tweeted out the link. Go to my page at Chris Cuomo, you'll see it. What is it? 6 very simple questions that you can ask anyone that you're worrying about. One of them is whatever they ever wished they could go to sleep and not wake up. Have they started collecting pills? Have they gotten a gun or given away valuables? Basic ways to help pick up crucial warning signs. All right, you're going to be skeptical, I understand. The Marine Corps rolled out this protocol for everyone to use, from legal assistance to members of clergy. What happened? Suicides among active duty Marines went down 22% in 2014. That's a big number. But here's the catch. Maybe it's not the magic of the questions. The catch is that the protocol works because people care enough to engage. That's another thing that is revealed by suicide, another dirty secret. We need to care. Caring counts. It can literally be medicine for someone in mental or emotional suffering. So reach out. Don't wonder what's going on with someone. Ask them. We are all